Hey, this particular video is similar to the last one about free spellcasters and whatnot. I was also asked specifically about a free love spell. And this is the reason why people in my position will not do free love spells for people. As I mentioned in the previous video, the karma, the effects of that work come back on the spiritual worker. So, for example, say for instance, you do a spiritual work for a person for free in regards to love. And something with that work goes, or something with that relationship goes astray, okay? Or let's say things go with the relationship goes right, okay? Let's say things with the relationship goes right. That person relationship may get better and your relationship, you may start having problems in your relationship. You know what I mean? I've seen these things happen. Me personally, I don't do free love spells for people. For that very reason, I will not do a free love spell for a person. Because I don't want any type of negative consequences or conditions coming back upon me for doing something for a person that did not put any interest in the game. Anybody that refused, because at that point they don't really believe in it. You know what I mean? When you're willing to invest in your desire, then you believe in the person's ability to bring about that desire. If you refuse to pay this person for their skill set, which is to be able to communicate with the spirit in such a way that they can get a occult force, a hidden force to work on your behalf and actually bring about a physical result, and you're not willing to pay that person to do that. Okay, at least so that they can pay the spirit, because these spirits have to be paid. These spirits have to be fed. Okay, these spirits have to be given a thanks for the things that they give to us. All right, so that person that you're doing the work for is not willing to give thanks to the spirit. They don't want to pay. The money is so that we can get things for the spirit in most cases. You know what I mean? Because people like me, we take care of spirits. We're masters of spirits. We take care of spirits on a daily basis. This is what we do for a living. This is what we do as a lifestyle. This is what we do as a spiritual faith, is we take care of spirits. You know what I'm saying? We make sure spirits are whole. We make sure that they have the energy that they need. We make sure that they're clean. Okay? We make sure that they're in a positive state. We make sure that they're not being obstructed from working in any type of way. We make sure that the energy around them is always positive and so forth. So when you asking for a love spell, let's say for instance, a person was to go to a Loa, or a person was to go to an Enkisi or an Orisha, and they promised that Orisha that if they performed the work for you, that they will come back and take care of that spirit, right? And then for whatever reason, that person may forget. Right now, it's on them. You understand what I'm saying? You out there living your best life. You having your relationship. The spirit and did the work and done everything for you, but the person, the actual spiritual worker, may get caught up in their everyday life, and they may forget. Oh shit! I was supposed to take some flowers to Oshun. Oh shit! I was supposed to do this for Mama Chola. Oh shit! I was supposed to do that for Urzuli, and now they shit fucked up. You see what I'm saying? So when you pay, it automatically sends a signal to our mind to say, okay, we got to get this, 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 and this. Boom, we giving it to the spirit immediately. So we ain't even finna fucking forget. You understand what I'm saying? We're not finna forget to take care of that spirit. We're not finna forget that, you know what I mean, they need that particular offering or whatever. I know that in traditions like Palo, for people like myself, who work Palo, you know what I'm saying, spirits like Chola want to get fed in advance. She want to get fed before she even start to work. So you have to give her what she needs when she's about to do that work. You know what I mean? So that there is no mishap of, oh, you forgot to give me this, you forgot to give me that. When you begin that work, you're going to find out what is it that I need for you to bring to do this work for me. Oh, you need to give me some flowers. Oh, you need to give me some honey. Oh, you need to give me this. Oh, you need to give me that. Oh, you need to wrap the work up like this, and you need to put this in the work. Oh, you may need to give me a heart from a dove. Or you may need to give me that or this. She gonna let you know what it is that you gotta give her so that she can do what she need to do. So this is why y'all gotta quit bullshitting out here looking for shit for free, because If you're looking for something for free, then you're gonna get free work. You're gonna get cheap work. You're gonna get shit that's not gonna work. You know what I'm saying? And then you're wasting that person's time if they even decide to do the work. Especially if you're getting somebody on the internet to do it. If you're getting somebody on the internet to do it, they may not even decide to do the damn work. You know what I mean? Because you ain't gave them shit. They don't have to. They can get around to it when they get around to it. You know what I mean? But when you pay for that work, you putting your interest in it, you letting the spirit know, look, my name is so-and-so. Here's my interest, my licencia, my donation to you. Because the money don't belong to us. Y'all be thinking that you got some of these cocky ass niggas out here who be like, oh, I'm getting money. Well, for people like me who are real spiritualists, the money don't belong to me. The money belongs to the spirit. The spirit just shares the money with me. You understand what I'm saying? The spirit shares the money with me. So I'm obligated to make sure that I take care of the spirit, that I pay the spirit. You know what I mean? So that's why I tell people when they owe me money, I'm like, shit, you don't owe me, you owe the spirit. And I don't chase them down. Anybody will tell you if they owe me money, I'm not finna chase you down. I'm not finna be messaging you talking about, hey, you got my money? You got my money? You got my money? You got my money? I'm not finna do that. I'm gonna let you know, look, you owe this, and you now owe the spirit. Now, if all of a sudden shit going good for you, and then all of a sudden that shit go left, that's your reminder, goddammit, that you were supposed to pay that spirit. They gonna leave your ass and they gonna stop working. You know what I mean? So free love spells, nah. Again, nah. You know what I mean? If I was you, I wouldn't even try to get no free love spell. And anybody that would do a free love spell for you, like I said, 9 times out of 10, it's going to be a family member or a good friend. And even if it's a good friend, they're going to say, well, look, you got to give me something. You got to give me $3. Go buy the candles or something. You know, go do something. You got to put some type of interest in the game. You know what I mean? Even a family member going to probably tell you, go get the candles. You're going to need to go down the street and give me a chicken or whatever the hell it is that they may need to do the work for you. They're going to make you go buy the shit, and then you come back and they just perform it for you. But you're going to put some skin in the game. You know what I mean? You're going to put some interest in the game. So free love spells, nah, I wouldn't say that you're going to be able to find that type of thing online anywhere. You know what I mean? Now, you can find out a way for you to do it yourself. You know what I mean? You can research or consult with a person like me. I can guide you. You can pay for a coaching session with me. And you know what I'm saying? I'll teach you to do, you know, love spells. Working in nature and so forth. I can't guarantee the success of what it is that you're going to do, but I'll definitely let you know what to do that gets me results and that actually works. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, as far as getting somebody like myself to perform a free love spell, no, I don't think that's going to happen. All right? So, again, y'all know the routine. Definitely subscribe to my channel. I appreciate y'all for watching. Follow me on social media. Follow my Instagram, my Twitter, my Facebook page. Check out the website. I'm actually in the process of writing a lot of articles on a lot of different subjects. So, you know, stay tuned. Peace.